What can be inferred about Adam Smith and Karl Marx? Where do we have this reference? The first paragraph refers to Smith and Marx and their two terms, and the second paragraph refers to certain works of the two economists and says that these works were influential. So we needed an answer choice on similar lines. Let's look at the answer choices. Answer choice A, their works inspired Keynes. The second paragraph mentions that Keynes' major work was as influential as the work of Marx and Smith. However, the passage doesn't suggest that the work of Marx and Smith inspired Keynes to write his theories. So this answer choice can be eliminated. Answer choice B, these theories supersede Keynesian economics in popularity and influence. The passage indicates that these theories are influential, but it doesn't suggest that these theories are more influential or supersede the theories by Keynes. So this answer choice can be eliminated. Answer choice C, their work had a profound influence on popular thought. Yes, the second paragraph mentions that these theories by Marx and Smith were influential. And also the first paragraph talks about certain terms introduced by Smith and Marx that got absorbed in popular ideology. So it is correct to state that the works of Smith and Marx are influential and popular. A good answer choice. Let's keep this on hold. Answer choice D, these ideas did not find popular support during the Great Depression in the 1930s. The second paragraph refers to the Great Depression in the 1930s in the context of the New Deal and Keynes's theory. So the passage makes no connection between Smith and Marx and the Great Depression. So let's eliminate this answer choice. Answer choice E, their influence is visible on the New Deal. Again, the second paragraph talks about the New Deal and how Keynesian theories influence the New Deal. The passage doesn't connect Smith and Marx and their theories with the New Deal. So this answer choice can be eliminated. C is the correct answer.